Hey everyone, I'm Leon, and in my last video, I showed you how to organize your fonts in Fontbook. I filmed that video 9 months ago. Anyway, things changed. I thought I would increase the number of videos I make. I figured that I could try to push the limits of the YouTube universe, and instead of making one video every decade, I figured I could make two every decade. Jokes aside, I can actually do three. So for my first video, I figured that I would show you 5 tips on how to make your websites in 2020 fast and snappy. Or at least faster than I can upload these videos. Alright, let's begin with number one. That is optimizing images. Images are everywhere and used a lot. It can make a huge difference to your website's performance and load times. So this makes it one of the most critical parts to get right on any website. The first thing you can do is make sure you use the right file types. Don't need transparency in an image? Use a JPEG instead. If you're using a lot of high resolution icons, maybe try using an SVG file format instead of a PNG. Also, make sure you have your images set on the proper size. By that I mean don't use 8,000 by 8,000 images on something small like a thumbnail on your website. Instead, try to crank down that resolution to something that's a little more appropriate for the use case. While you're turning down the resolution of your images, I would also highly recommend minifying them / compressing them. I use an app called ImageOptim to reduce the footprint of my images. This app cleans up all the unnecessary metadata that's probably embedded into your image and various other things like compression. What I like about this app is you can just drag a whole folder into it and it will automatically optimize all images that are within that folder and all various other subfolders as well. It's a very useful feature because then you don't have to worry about optimizing an image as soon as you drag it into the directory in case you forget about it later. Instead, you can focus on creating your beautiful masterpiece, and when it's time, you can just drag a whole image folder into ImageOptim and the app handles the rest. This app only works on Mac, however, so if you're on Windows, a great alternative to this is a service called Optimizilla, and just its same drag and drop features, and like ImageOptim, you just drag the files in and it handles the rest. I will leave a link to everything that I mentioned in the description down below, so if you want to check any of them out, they're all in one place. Another thing that I want to mention is lazy loading images. This can be very useful because it can save data and system resources for users who probably won't even see an image that's maybe deeper in the post or all the way down at the footer, for example. So you want to make sure that those images aren't being loaded and waste resources when they're not needed, and that's what lazy loading does. Number two, minify files. If you're working on a big or even an average website, chances are you're organizing your life by separating things into multiple CSS files, multiple JavaScript files, and you probably also use a lot of comments and a lot of white space. I get it, it's clean and organized, makes your life easier, that's fine. But when you upload your site to the server, all that white space and comments mean nothing, make no difference, but they can add up to much bigger file sizes. So make sure you minify your files before you deploy them to the server. If you are using Visual Studio Code as your code editor of choice, there is an extension called Minify. It's very customizable and flexible, so you can adapt it to your workflow however you want, so I would highly recommend checking it out. If you're not using code as your editor of choice, then I recommend checking out a website called minifier.org. There you can just copy-paste your CSS or JavaScript file and it's gonna minify it automatically, and then you can just copy and paste it back to a .min or however you call your minified file names, and you're good to go. Number three, minimize HTTP requests. In case you're not sure what that is, an HTTP request is a request that your browser makes to the server whenever it needs to grab a certain file. For example, that can include all your style sheets, your JavaScript files, all your images, videos, fonts, etc. And the more HTTP requests your browser has to make, the more back and forth trips you're making between the browser and the server, which can increase load time and add more strain to the server that's serving those files. You obviously can't lower this number down to just one HTTP request, but there are certain things you can do to help the server out. You can do things like combine all your CSS style sheets into just one file, same thing with JavaScript, and use lazy loading for various things like images and videos on your site so they're not even requested unless a user gets to that specific section. This might not seem like it makes a huge difference, but when your server needs to serve thousands of HTTP requests, one can make a huge difference. Number four, use a CDN. A CDN stands for Content Delivery Network, and it can help you out serve most frequently used files like style sheets, JavaScript files to browsers. Think about minimizing HTTP requests for your server. This can also help your server out because CDN acts like a middleman for serving the files. For example, when a browser goes to access your website, it will first go through a CDN, and only will the CDN request the files from the server if they're not cached on the CDN or otherwise just not available there. This can be very helpful. Not only are you offloading your server, but a CDN most likely has better resources and more bandwidth available than your average shared hosting machine. It also helps out because a CDN is a widespread network, so your files are hosted through various different locations in the world. So when a user goes to your site, they will go through a server that is more closer to their location, which can help reduce response and load times. There's a pretty popular one out there, which is called Cloudflare. You probably heard of it. It does exactly what I mentioned above. Number five, First Contentful Paint, or FCP for short. When a user goes to your site, they start loading an HTML document in order: head, body, footer. Most of the time, you find yourself in a situation where a website loads quickly, but sometimes that's not the case, and a lot of people usually load sites a little bit slower. And usually when you load a site, you start seeing bits and pieces pop up as they load. And you want to make sure that the most critical files are loaded first. For example, your style sheet. You want to make sure that at least you're not using the generic font while the rest of the site is still loading. This is one part of the web experience that I highly recommend investing your time into, because your users will appreciate if the website looks nice as it's loading in. Some sites might have a little splash screen, a little loading logo while the site loads. Some websites might have a progress bar at the top, like for example, like YouTube. Overall, you just want to make sure that you still provide a great user experience even while the website is not fully loaded yet. So that's what FCP stands for. All right, and those are my 5 tips on how you can optimize your websites for 2020. I hope this video helped you out. If you have any more tips that you would like to share that I didn't mention in this video, please leave them in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions for future videos I should make, remember I still do 2 this decade, you can leave those in the comments as well. All right, everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the future, probably in 2021 or whenever I make another video. So see you then.